Okay, class, good morning. So, this will be our first topic for midterm, the classification of taxpayer and taxable sources of income. So, start na tada yun, ah, para dasig lang ta. Then, we have here the classification of taxpayer and taxable sources of income. We have the resident citizen. By the way, class, we'll discuss this one by one for the next slides. But for the overview, we have here the taxpayer and the taxable sources. So first is the resident citizen. So the taxable sources of a resident citizen is all sources. That's within and without the Philippines. No? Basi matingala ka mo, I use the term without. No? Muna siya ginagamit sa tax. Synonymous to outside the Philippines. No? Within and without. Non-resident citizen within the Philippines, ang iyang taxable income. Overseas contract worker, ang seaman, within. Resident alien within the Philippines, non-resident alien, still within. Domestic corporation, the same as resident citizen, all sources, no? They are a Filipino company that is organized in our Philippine laws, no? Based on Philippine laws. Then foreign corporation, that's within the Philippines, ang nila taxable sources. So let's pick this up one by one. First is the resident citizen. A citizen of the Philippines residing therein is taxable on all income derived from sources within and without the Philippines. So resident ka na, citizen ka pa, no? You are staying here in the Philippines as a resident, and you are a Filipino citizen. You are a resident citizen, taxpayer. So your source, your taxable income, all income derived from sources within and without the Philippines. So for example is, nag-uubra ka sa... you are working here in the Philippines and you are also working for a foreign corporation or based outside the Philippines. So your income from your or from your compensation in the corporation here in the Philippines is taxable, and also your income that you are deriving from the foreign corporation you are working with, which is based outside the Philippines, is also taxable. So that's resident citizen. Income derived within and without the Philippines is taxable. Next is the non-resident citizen. So a non-resident citizen is taxable only on income derived from sources within the Philippines. Who are these non-resident citizens? So those are Filipino citizen staying abroad for at least 183 days, no? You are staying there for at least 183 days. You are still a Filipino citizen, but you are not staying na dere sa Philippines, no? For 183 days. Okay? Okay, staying abroad for at least 183 days. So tunga ka sa tuig na dula di sa Philippines. That's a non-resident citizen. Next is the overseas contract worker or seaman. So an individual citizen of the Philippines who is working and deriving income from abroad as an overseas contract worker is taxable only on income derived from sources within the Philippines. So same man sila sa non-resident citizen, kay taxable ang ila income within the Philippines only. Napagid. No, they are considered overseas contract worker siya. Yeah. No, so a seaman is a citizen of the Philippines and who receives compensation for services rendered abroad as a member of the complement of a vessel engaged exclusively in international trade shall be treated as an overseas contract worker. So, a seaman working in a company engaged exclusively in international trade, so they are considered as overseas contract worker. So not all seamen are overseas contract worker class, since we have seamen man diri sa Philippines nga working in a local company, ano, the Super Ferry, Supercat, napagid, mga barko na bala, local lang, inter-island na ang tawag sa ila. So they are not considered as overseas contract worker class. Kaya you will be considered an OCW if you are working, no, maniho? You are rendering services abroad, no, as a member of the complement of a vessel engaged exclusively in international trade. So that's OCWs. No, so klaro na ta dira, their income are taxable within the Philippines. So next is resident alien, no? So kadlaw ka sa term alien, but they are considered people man Japan, ha, hindi na ya alien nga halin sa lain nga planeta. So when we speak of resident alien, an alien individual, whether a resident or not of the Philippines, is taxable only on income derived from sources within the Philippines. So you are considered a resident alien if you are staying in the Philippines for more than 1 year as of the taxable period. You are not a Filipino citizen, but you are a resident thereof, and you are staying in the Philippines for more than 1 year. Then you will be considered a resident alien. So your income will be taxable within the Philippines. Okay, gets nyo na ang resident alien, no? They are not Filipino citizens, class, ha? They are foreigners who are residents, who became residents of the Philippines, no? Staying in the Philippines for more than 1 year. Those are the resident aliens. So we have here non-resident alien. So you are non-resident of the Philippines and you are a foreigner. So an alien individual, whether a resident or not of the Philippines, is taxable only on income derived from sources within the Philippines. So non-resident alien, you are not a resident of the Philippines and you are not a citizen of the Philippines. So non-resident alien, we have two, the ETB or engaged in trade or business. No, you are not non-resident alien engaged in trade or business, and a non-resident alien not engaged in trade or business. So who are those non-resident alien engaged in trade or business? So those are staying in the Philippines for not more than 1 year, but more than 180 days. So they are staying in the Philippines for more than 180 days, but not more than 1 year. So 100, so they are staying in the Philippines for half a year. No, more than 1 year, but more than, not more than 1 year, but more than 180 days. So less than 365 days, but more than 180 days. So you are a non-resident alien who is engaged in trade or business. So who are those non-resident alien who are not engaged in trade or business? So those are staying in the Philippines for not more than 180 days. So they just stayed in the Philippines only for less than 180 days. So you will be considered as a non-resident alien not engaged in trade or business. No? So whether you are an NRA, ETB, or NRA, NETB, your income derived within the Philippines is only taxable. So muna siya class ang NRA, ETB, and NRA, NETB. So next is we have the domestic corporation. So same ni siya sa resident citizen, no? Domestic corporation are those corporation that are organized in the Philippines and based on Philippine laws, no? So a domestic corporation is taxable on all income derived from sources within and without the Philippines. So they are the same with resident citizen, no? Corporation na siya galing. So here, next is foreign corporation. So a foreign corporation, whether engaged or not in trade or business in the Philippines, is taxable only on income derived from sources within the Philippines. So foreign corporation within the Philippines, ang taxable nilang ha, income. So we have here ang non-resident citizen. So how will you prove or how will you consider yourself as a non-resident citizen? So we have here a citizen of the Philippines who establishes to the satisfaction of the commissioner the fact of his physical presence abroad with a definite intention to reside therein. So you must present to the commissioner that you will be or you will have a physical presence abroad and you have a definite intention to reside therein. So therefore, you will be considered a non-resident citizen. Next is a citizen of the Philippines who leaves the Philippines during the taxable year to reside abroad, no? Masaylo ka na to, either as an immigrant or for employment on a permanent basis. So you will immigrating outside the Philippines, no? Ano naman ang country, and or you are working or you will be based there on a permanent basis, no? Sa isa ka foreign corporation nandito sa Guasang Philippines. So you will be considered a non-resident citizen. So a citizen of the Philippines who works and derives income from abroad and whose employment thereat requires him to be physically present abroad most of the time during the taxable year. So if you are working on working abroad, pero ari ka pa di sa Philippines, but eventually you will be required to be physically present there and most of the time atukato, then you will be considered a non-resident citizen. So muna siya class. Next is a citizen who has been previously considered as non-resident citizen and who arrives in the Philippines at any time during the taxable year to reside permanently in the Philippines shall likewise be treated as a non-resident citizen for the taxable year in which he arrives in the Philippines with respect to his income derived from sources abroad until the date of his arrival in the Philippines. So as you can see, sa ginhatag ko da nga notes, no, ligad, may ara dira nga first you are a NRC, non-resident citizen, no? So nagpuli ka di sa Philippines kay diri ka naman may star. So for example, nagpuli ka May 1. So May 1 onwards, you became a resident citizen, but before May 1, you will be considered as non-resident citizen. So duwa imo classification within the taxable year, no? So kung ano ang treatment sa imong income when you are a non-resident citizen that would apply for the taxable year and kung ano ang income nga na-derive mo when you became a resident citizen sang nagpuli ka na di sa Philippines will likewise be treated as taxable within and without kay nag-resident citizen ka na. So amo na siya class. Then the taxpayer shall submit proof to the commissioner to show his intention of leaving the Philippines to reside permanently abroad or to return to and reside in the Philippines as the case may be. So you must submit a proof to the commissioner to show your intention of living in the Philippines and reside abroad permanently. Kay base balaklas nga nagwa ka lang sa Philippines to escape na from your tax liabilities diri sa Philippines, so you must submit proof to the commissioner that you will become a non-resident citizen. Now you have intention of leaving the Philippines to reside permanently abroad so that you will become a non-resident citizen. Or otherwise, no? Return to and reside in the Philippines as the case may be, so that you will become a resident citizen. So that's it, class. No? To recap, amo to siya una-una, for resident citizen, your taxable sources are all sources. Non-resident citizen, that's within the Philippines. OCWs, the seaman, within. Resident alien, within. Non-resident alien, within. And domestic corporation, all sources, that's within and without. And foreign corporation, within. So that ends our first topic in our midterm. So we'll have another video tomorrow. Hopefully, I could make it since tatlo ka subject ko bukas sa aga. Ako ni Moon, since hapon, I will not be available in making videos until evening. So, if wala taxation bus, more or less, that would be on Friday. So, thank you very much, class. Thank you. God bless.